Okay children, as we have done with the lesson, that is nouns number, and in this lesson we have studied the different cases, that how to form the singular nouns into plural nouns. Now if you turn to the next page over here, see here we have completed with the 9 cases. That first case I told you we have to add s. Second one I told you, if the nouns are ending with s, double s, sh, ch or x, we have to add es. Second, the third case was, if the noun is ending with o, we have to add es. If the nouns are ending with f or fe, we have to add ves. And if the nouns are ending with consonant plus y, then we have to add ies. And if the nouns are ending with the vowel, any vowel plus y, then we have to add over s over here. This was some of the cases. Besides those cases, we have studied three more cases, that some words, they do not follow these rules what we have learned. There are some other three rules, that is some nouns there we have to add suffixes to make them plural, and some nouns are if you see this one, I told you this one, if you see here, some they are the singular nouns, but we have to change some of the letters to make them plural. They have given o here. Then if you see the last rule was what, or the last case, if you see the words, the nouns which do not change in the plural form also, in the singular form also they are the same, and in the plural form also they are the same. Now next one we will be moving forward. See here, to know whether the word is being used as a singular or plural form, we have to understand the sentence. Children, you are supposed to understand the sentence itself, what the sentence is telling, then only you will be knowing that whether we have to, whether the sentence is in a singular or a plural noun. So we have to try to understand what is the sentence. Now some of the examples they have given, and you are going to try to understand what the sentence tries to tell you. If you see the first example, the child wanted to see a deer. Now you have learned in the previous cases that here the word or this noun in the singular form also it is same, and in the plural form also it is same. So the child wanted to see a deer. But if you want to change this sentence into plural, are you going to add s, or are you going to add es or ves? No, because you have learnt that this sentence, in this sentence you have learnt this, you have learnt the case that if some nouns they do not change in the singular form also and in the plural form also. So they have, here it is given deer, and if you see the, this is the singular form of sentence. But if you see in the plural one, when he went to the zoo, he saw many deer. Many deer. So plural of deer is deer only. Means they do not change the form. In the singular also they are same, and in the plural also they are same. So this one sentence was there. If you see the next sentence, several sheep were grazing in the field. Several sheep, this is plural. Okay, if you see some sheep in the we can say in the field, there is no one sheep. If it is one also, we are going to say it as sheep only. And if it is more than one also, we are going to say it as sheep only. Means the singular form will not change. The singular form will be as it is, and even in the plural form also, it will be as it is. So here it is sheep. Several sheep were grazing in the field. This is plural form as it is. But if you want to change it into singular, you are not going to add s here or es or ves, anything, because the singular form or plural form will be as it is. They are not going to change. So in the singular sentence also, if you see, a sheep was black in color. Here a single sheep is also sheep only, and here the plural sheep is also sheep only. So some of these words are exceptional, that they do not change in the singular form also nor in the plural form also. Now we saw many colorful fish in the aquarium. Plural, you see, children, you may be saying that fish, we can write it as fishes also in the plural form. But something I will later on, I'm going to explain why we don't say es, or why we don't add es to fishes. I'll tell you that later on, you'll come to know. But if you see, we saw many colorful fish in the aquarium. This is plural only because I will tell you, Popo was a fish who went on an adventure. First sentence they have given in the plural form also fish as it is, singular form fish as it is. Now this we are going to study why these words are kept as it is in the next case. See what they here what it is given, but sometimes we use fishes also. You may be saying, children, sometimes we use fishes also, we add es also. Why we do not add es? See, they have given here, we saw many kinds of fishes in the pond. Now if you suppose there is one pond, and in that pond there are many varieties of fishes will be there, many varieties will be there. If there it is only one variety of fish, then we are going to use that fish only for singular also and for the plural also. Okay, but if there are varieties of fish in the pond or in the aquarium, then we are going to add es, and that will be fishes. They have given an example. They are telling, we saw many kinds of fishes in the pond. Means in the pond there were varieties of fish. There was not only one type of fish. There were varieties of fish. Then that time we are going to add es. That time we are going to add es. Okay. Similarly, fruit is used in the singular. Fruit is also used in the singular. You say, children, sometimes that we should have fruit with breakfast every day. We should have fruit with breakfast every day. Now, here means what it is? You are going to eat, suppose if you are going to eat an apple every day in the breakfast, means you are eating only one variety of fish, fruit. We should have fruit with breakfast every day. Suppose you are eating an orange, means only orange is one type of fruit. So that's why we are using your fruit. But if you are eating varieties of fruit, if you are eating an orange, if you are eating an apple, banana, or any other fruit, then that time we are going to write fruits. If you are eating only one variety of fruit in the breakfast, then you are going to write it as fruit. And then too, if suppose you are eating many fruit, you are eating oranges, 3-4 oranges you are eating in the breakfast, but you are going to write it as fruit only because that is of one variety. But if you are eating an apple in your breakfast, you are eating an apple, you are eating banana, or you are eating orange, you are eating an orange. So these are the three types of, these are the varieties of fruit, apple, banana, orange. These are the varieties of fruit, and then we are going to, that time we are going to use the word fruits over here, because here we find the varieties of fruits. But if you are eating, suppose if you are eating only orange, you are eating only orange, and you are eating three oranges in the breakfast, you are eating three oranges in the breakfast, that will be one variety because only orange you are eating, and that time you are going to use the word fruit because you are eating only one variety of fruit. So you are going to, if it is a plural also, if you are eating more than one fruit but it is of one variety, then you are going to use the word fruit. But if you are eating the varieties of fruits in the breakfast, then it may be one or it may be more than one, then that time you are going to use the word fruits. The same case it was with the fish. If in the pond only one variety of fish is there, only one variety of fish is there, you are going to use this word as plural because here it is of one variety. It is of one variety. But in the pond, suppose in the pond there are varieties of fish. If there are varieties of fish, then you are going to write it as fishes. Okay, then you are going to write it as fishes. This is some of the other cases. Now again, if you see the third sentence they have given, the third sentence they have given here, There are some the other case is what now? There are some other nouns which have only one plural form. They have only one plural form. We have seen the two sentences again one time. I'll explain with that. If we are talking about only one variety of fish, and if it is plural, if there is more than one fish, then that time we are going to use only fish. And if there are varieties of fishes and they are more than in number, then we are going to add es, and that will be fishes. Then the other example they have given here like that, we should have fruit. If we have one fruit in the breakfast, one fruit in the breakfast, and it is of one variety, then that, if it is plural also, if it is more than in number, we are going to say it as fruit. But if there are varieties of fruits and if it is more in numbers, then we are going to say it as fruits. Now the other example, if you see other case, if you see, there are some nouns, see, like this, which have only plural forms, they are not in the singular form. Now trousers, children, you wear your pant. Do you have only one leg or what for that pant? No, you have both the legs, isn't it? Both the sides are there. Now specs, if you take the spectacles, here if you see the spectacles, you are not going to say spectacles, only specs. Only one glass is there, there is a word, if only one glass is there, a word for the specs? No, both the glasses are there, isn't it? Then if you see the knife, scissors also, there is a pair of scissors, we say, okay, because only one blade is not there for the scissor, or jeans or clothes. So here some nouns, they have only plural forms, they do not have singular forms. Trousers, spectacles, jeans, scissors and clothes, these nouns, some nouns, they have only plural forms. For example, they have given trousers. The trousers do not fit you. Trousers means the pant which you wear. The trousers do not fit you. You are not going to say trouser. Trouser means that will be only one side of your pant. So both the sides are there. So the trousers. Scissors are sharp, so handle them carefully. For the scissors, there is no only one blade. We say two blades are there. So scissors. Then clothes are brought from Jaipur. See, you wear the full clothes. So the clothes are also plural. They do not have any singular form. All these words, they are in the plural forms. This is also one case. Now next, if you see, as here you have seen, they have only the plural forms. Here some of the words, they are only in the singular forms. For example, furniture. Now in the furniture, there may be table, chair, a bench, desk, many or cupboard, we can say, in the furniture, all these things are there, but they all are counted as furniture only. Furniture means not only table. If you take furniture as tables, then if you take chair, or if you take cupboard, these all are the furniture. They all are counted as furniture only, and we count it as singular only. News. Now in the news, there may be in all the languages you can hear the news, many news will be there, but you don't take it as plural because there are many news over, and you take it as only singular. Now information also, there may be information about any subject, any new information may be there. All types of information may be there, but we are not going to say informations. We are going to say it as information only. So these are some of the words which are used only as singular, in the singular forms. As we have done with this, these are some of the words which are only in the plural forms, and these are some of the words which are only in the singular form. So suppose if you come to through all these words, you remember properly that how to use them in means you are supposed to see that whether it is in if they are only in the plural form or if they are only in the singular form. Don't try to change them, this singular into plural or this plural into singular. They will be in the plural forms only, not in singular, and these words will be only in the singular, not in the plural form. I hope children have understood till here. So these were some of the other cases. What was first one? Just now I told you some nouns, like to know whether the word is being used as a singular or plural, we have to see that some words they are used singular also and plurals. For example, I told you like deer, sheep and fish and all these words. And some words like some nouns they are used only in the plural form and some words they are used only in the singular form. Now we'll go to the next exercise. See here. Write the plural forms of the following singular nouns. Here they have given all the words, these nouns are given. You are going to change this. Write the plural forms. You are going to write it into the plural forms of the singular nouns. They have given the singular nouns. Now you are going to change it into plural over here. So first one is ox. So here you are going to add suffix, that is oxen. This will be the plural. Now roof, here you are going to add only s. This is an exceptional word for es. So you are going to, this word is ending with f. Now I told you if it is ending with f or fe, you have to add es. But some exceptional words are there, if they are ending with y, f or fe, we are going to add only s. Now child, here you are going to add suffix and make it children. Then photo, this is also an exceptional word. Here I told you if the word is ending with o, you are going to add es. But this is the exceptional word, so only s you are going to add, that is photos. Then here the word is ending with f, so you are going to add it as V-E-S, V-E-S. This is ending with L-F, so sorry, this is ending with only F, so this will be shelves. Here also we are going to add V-E-S. Now family, this is ending with Y. I told if it is ending with consonant plus Y, then that will be I-E-S, that is families. And if it is ending with this word, I told you here you are not supposed to change any, you have to change the letters over here and make it plural. Now mouse will be mice. So these all were the plural forms of the singular nouns. They have given ox, that will be oxen, roof will be roofs, child will be children, photo will be photos, calf will be calves, shelf will be shelves, family will be families and mouse will be mice. Now see exercise. If you see, we'll move to the next exercise, that is change the nouns printed in bold into their plural forms. Change the nouns printed in bold into the plural forms. What did you see? Change the nouns printed in bold into the plural forms. Now which are the nouns, here the nouns are printed in bold. This child and woman. These nouns you are going to change into plural. They are given in singular, you are going to change it into plural. How you are going to change now, see. The child, what will be the plural of child? That will be children. The children played with the woman. This is the plural. Okay, in this way you are going to change the sentence. The children played with the woman. Singular you have changed into plural. These bold letters, bold words which are the sentences, you are going to change into singular to plural. Second sentence, if you take, give me the scissors. Now scissors you are going to change into plural. Are you going to change it? No, because I told you some nouns they do not change their plural form. This itself, it is a plural. So give me the scissors, it will be as it is. Next, if you see, we found the photo. This photo you are going to change into plural now. We found the photos. You have changed it into plural form now. Next, we need to shift the furniture to our new house. Furniture to house. So you are going to change it into furniture to house now. We need to shift the furniture. Furniture, I told you, it is singular form. So it will be as it is. We need to shift the furniture to our new house. Are you going to change it? No. This will be as it is. We need to shift the furniture to our new house. Then the news reached us on time. The news, we have seen in the sentence, the news will be news as it is singular form. It will be as it is. News reached us on time. It will be as it is. Then we found the knife in the kitchen. Knife, you are going to change it into plural. See, we found the knife. Now your fe, this fe, we are going, if it is ending with fe, you are going to add ves. So knives. We found the knives in the kitchen. Next, the cat ran after the mouse. The cat ran after the mouse. So the cat and mouse, you are going to change it into plural. The cats ran after the mice. Okay. Then the ox scared away the dog. The ox and this dog, you are going to change. The oxen scared away the dogs. The oxen scared away the dogs. In this way, the nouns which are printed in bold, they are changed into plural forms. In this way, you are going to solve the exercise. See, first one I have given, the child played with the woman. This one, the child played with the woman. The child will be children. The children played with the women. This is the plural form of woman, women. Second, give me the scissors. Scissors is what? This itself, it is a plural form. So, you are not going to change it. Give me the scissors. Third, we found the photo. Now, photo, you are going to change it into plural. We found the photos. Fourth is, we need to shift the furniture to our new house. Then, furniture is the singular form. Okay, singular, and this also we are not supposed to change. We need to shift the furniture as it is to our new house. The news reached us on time. News is the singular form, and this will be as it is. If you want to make it plural also, it will be as it is. The news reached us on time. Sixth one, we found the knife in the kitchen. Knife will turn into knives. We found the knives in the kitchen. Next, the cat ran after the mouse. The cats, the plural of cat is cats, mouse is mice. The cats ran after the mice. And next is the oxen, ox, and this is dog. The oxen scared away the dogs. In this way, you are going to change the nouns printed in bold in the plural forms. I hope children you have understood all this exercise. So once again we will recall with the nouns number. This is the nouns number, and here there are several cases to change the singular form into plural forms. So first one is what? First one, if you see, the first one is, first case is what? First one is what? Here you are going to add s to the singular noun to make them plural. Then second case is what? If the nouns are ending with s, or if it is ending with double s, or if it is ending with sh, or if it is ending with ch, or if it is ending with x, we are going to add es to the singular noun. And if the nouns are ending with o, then we are going to add es. And if the nouns are ending with f or fe, we have to change them into plural form by adding ves. Then if the noun is the nouns are ending with consonant plus y, then it will change into, we are going to add ies to make them plural. And if the nouns are ending with vowels plus y, then we are going to add only s to the singular form. So we have done with that exercise. I told you, for examples they have given, that desk, brush, 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 brushes, dress, dresses, bench, benches, beach, beaches, dish, dishes, radio, radios, roof, roofs, army, armies, shelf, shelves, window, windows, wife, wives, pen, pens, box, boxes, glass, glasses, and boy, boys. Then next rule was, it was that we have to add suffix to make them plural form. We have to add suffix to make them plural form. This was the next case. And next way, the other case was what? If the, in the some nouns, if you want to make them plural, you have to change, so here you have to change some of the letters and make them plural. Then the other form was what? If you want to make them singular, some words are, we have to keep as it is over here. See, we have to keep some words as it is. Here if you see, like sheep. Like sheep, deer, fish. These are some of the words where we can't change them in the plural form. We have to keep these words as it is. So once again I'll tell you, first one, first case is what? We have to add s to make them plural. Second case is, we have to add, first case is what? We have to add s. Second is, we have to, if it is ending with s, double s, ch, sh, or x, we have to add here es. Okay, then third one, if it, if the word is ending with o, you are going to, here also you are going to add es. Then if the word, if the nouns, they are ending, if the nouns are ending with like we can say, if they are ending with y, then here you are going to add ies. And if the noun, if the nouns are ending with the consonant plus y, consonant plus y, here you are going to add ies. If the nouns are ending with vowel, this is consonant plus y, if the nouns are ending with vowel plus y, then that time also you are going to add only s over here. Okay. And suppose if the nouns are ending with f or fe, here you are going to add ves. These are the six cases. Besides this six cases, there the other rules are what? If the nouns are in the singular and if you want to make it them plural, you are going to add suffixes. Or some words or some nouns, there we have, we are not going to, here we are going to change only the letters to make them plural. And some singular nouns, there we are not going to change any letters. The words will be as it is, if they are, if though we have turned them into plural. And the other thing is what? Here also, if you see, we have to see the sentences to know whether the word is being used as a singular or plural noun. We have to understand the sentences. And next one, if you see, the next case, if you want to see, the some nouns are, they all already, they all are in the plural forms only, so we can't change them. And some nouns, they all are in the singular nouns, singular form only, so there also we can't change. So as we have done with the exercise B and exercise C, so this was all about the nouns number, and you have to follow the cases to make them, if you want to make them plural, you have to by heart these cases, you have to try to understand these cases, and some more examples you have to use, and some more examples you have to take and try to make try to practice this nouns number. So this was all about the nouns number. I hope children you have understood what all cases you are going to use them to turn the singular noun into the plural. So just go through all the exercises again and practice it properly. Thank you.